Hey guys, welcome to the second video of the series Things You May Have Missed in Genshin Impact. In the previous video, we had a look at 5 things at Liyue, and if you haven't yet checked it out, there is a link down in the description below. So anyway, for this episode, we're going to talk about 5 things you may have missed while adventuring throughout Mondstadt, the first region where we start our journey. Just to clarify, I will exclude the area of Dragonspine as that will most likely have its own episode. Alright, without further delay, let's get right into the essence of this video with thing you may have missed in Mondstadt number 1. The truth about Venti's alcohol tolerance. It's a rather small detail, but it made me laugh when I first did it, and I hope you don't mind I'm putting it here on the list. For those who haven't yet done Jean's story quest, spoilers ahead. So anyway, before you finish the story quest for Jean, you and the other knights prepare a surprise feast for Jean. Then, when the feast has started, you will get a chance to roam around Angel's Share. You know, the tavern owned by Diluc. So, before you head upstairs to talk to Jean, you get a scene where you can hear Diluc keeping count of Venti's shots.
That's glass number 37.
What's Diluc doing?
I'm keeping count of this bard's alarming pace of progress through my wine. Only the knights drink for free tonight. It seems he didn't get the message. When he sobers up, I will present him with the bill.
Diluc, you're a meanie.
I'm joking, of course. I highly doubt he could afford it anyway, so I shall spare him the bill. But I must say, the sheer volume of alcohol this fellow can put back is just not normal.
So anyway, it's just a scene that people tend to forget aware Venti, the animal archon, is shown that he can hold his liquor greatly. I kinda wanted him to take more shots, and we could see where he would pass out. Amber is also seen to be drunk here, and it's just a fun detail that makes this game a great one. Right, now moving on to thing you may have missed in Mondstadt number 2, the fate of Amber's grandfather. So, as we all know, Amber is the only outrider of the Knights of Favonius. However, life in the Knights was not easy for Amber in the beginning. She experienced emotional trauma from the disappearance of her grandfather. We are not sure, however, who or where her parents are, but as we read her character's story, it is said that her grandfather was the one who raised her and took care of her. Anyway, her grandfather then disappeared all of a sudden. He left his equipment and gear in his office with no note as to where or why he left. For those who don't know, Amber's grandfather was a leader of a Liyue mercenary group. He then went to Mondstadt after having failed his mission to protect a merchant caravan. So as he went to Mondstadt, he joined the Knights of Favonius and was the one who founded the Outrider Division. Her grandfather would lead them into expeditions and personally train them too, kinda like an Erwin Smith version of Genshin. So, when Amber's grandfather disappeared without a trace, the Outriders lost all hope and one by one disbanded. So back to the emotional trauma Amber dealt with. She had not expected this to happen because of the fact that she always had a positive outlook on life. This was actually her first time dealing true loss and disappointment. However, she continued to move forward and grew to become an Outrider just like her grandfather, keeping the legacy of the Outrider Division. Now let's head to the topic at hand. Apparently, there is a text found in a notice board from Chinse Village and seems very much like what we know about Amber's grandfather. It is delivered from a first-person perspective, maybe a friend of Amber's grandfather? So anyway, we can read that someone had returned to Chinse Village after 50 years. For the second text, it is said that the writer and that someone were hired mercenaries and that he later went to Mondstadt to become a knight. This implying the Knights of Favonius. From this text, it is clear that this fits with Amber's grandpa's story. Now if we continue reading the text, there are hints at something memory related. Apparently, Amber's grandfather seems to have Alzheimer's disease, which causes memory loss. Amber's grandfather might have forgotten the life he had in Mondstadt and that he has a lovely granddaughter. This story was actually heartbreaking and actually caught me by surprise because it was really sad upon knowing the truth. I certainly wanted to share it with you, knowing the fact that Amber was left alone with no explanation and could have been the one to take care of her grandfather. I guess we will know more in her future story quest chapter. And so, I think that's all I have for number 2. If any of you guys know more, don't hesitate to share it down in the comments below. So now off to the third one, The Adventures of Alice, Klee's Mom. So, we all don't actually know where Alice is or what she looks like. If you finished the Act 1 of the story quest for Mona, it is mentioned that Mona's teacher is friends slash rivals with Alice and is also skilled in many mystic arts. So anyway, back when she was adventuring, she began writing the Tibet Travel Guide, which is actually more of a diary than a travel guide. From there, we can read about the experiments she wanted to perform, including a genocide of the Hilichurls, and her thoughts about some certain characters such as Amber, Jean, and Kaya. So for the first one, she actually criticized Venti due to being undisciplined, you know, because of how Venti acts childishly. Anyway, Alice mentioned that she wanted to place bombs in certain positions to make them become flatter. Can you imagine if Klee had the same idea as her mother? Jean would be so stressed that she could faint in any minute. So moving on to Alice's next entry, she mentioned that she grabbed some Hilichurls just to prove a theory of as to how Vanessa ascended from the huge oak tree located at Windrise. Apparently, she used the Hilichurls as the launching device and does not care if she kills them. Do any of you guys feel bad for the Hilichurls? Well, because I do. So for the next one, and this is what shocked me while reading this, Alice and Zhongli traveled together, and it is mentioned that while in Juyun Karst, Alice theorized that the location should find itself back underwater as this place used to be a reservoir and not a part of a mountain. Zhongli or Morax then laughed at her, maybe because she made a wrong theory or something. She also then saw a weirdo living on the top floor of Wangshu Inn, and describes him to not speak a single word. The weirdo she mentions here was Xiao, and I found that very interesting because in the future, we may get to see a cutscene of Klee meeting Xiao or Zhongli. Oh, and I forgot to mention that Alice was also the one who blew up those holes at Storm Terror's lair, right here shown in the video. Lastly, there was a theory that Zhongli may be Klee's father? I'm not really sure. Maybe because they used to travel together and that sounds like a potential romance? Who knows? Let's just wait for future updates, and that is all I have for number 3. Now before I move on to number 4 and several bonus ones, let me take a brief moment of your time and ask you to like this video if you've enjoyed it thus far and to also consider enabling notifications for our channel to make sure you don't miss any of our uploads and get notified on time, provided of course, if that is what you actually want. I totally understand if you don't, and it's absolutely fine. Now let's get onto the thing you may have missed number 4, the secret of Dawn Winery. So I was wandering around Dawn Winery at night, and then started to talk to the two maids, and they were talking about how their guests mysteriously disappear from their rooms. So when they ask Adelinda about it, she just ignores them. Now if you also ask her about it, she just tells you to shake it off and gives you some delicious thick honey roast from normal animal meat and then chuckles afterwards. I was actually creeped out at that. I soon discovered that that meat was actually from their guests. Imagine Adeline gives us 6 suspicious steaks with the context a grilled steak, its color is a little bleak, almost as if it was sorry for itself for being an excuse for a steak. Counting from the 6 pieces, which could be deducted to 2 legs, 2 arms, 1 torso, and 1 head. This is concluded as human flesh. To add more proof, there is a dialogue between Moko and Hilly, the other two maids at Dawn Winery, saying that Adelinda has 1 extra key on her, implying that there is a secret room that can be found inside the Dawn Winery mansion. It also says that one of them found the secret door, and when she got close, she suddenly heard a thud sound getting closer. Apparently, that was the sound of how Adelinda walks. Another one is, Adelinda is also part of Deluxe Underground's intel network, and they probably invite some people and interrogate them and disappear afterwards. There were some people who said that the secret room is like the Batcave of Diluc, because of how he sneaks at night and does Batman stuff, and that Adolin is like the Alfred of Diluc. Some also say that there is a secret guest inside the Dawn Winery, and that is Kaya. We actually have no evidence yet about this, but what we can finally conclude is that Adolin is a cannibal and serves as steaks made from human guests. Okay, time for thing number 5, and we're getting close to the end. How Starsnash Cliff was formed. As you may have noticed, Mondstadt has many high plateaus, and the region was inspired from Germany. Now if you head on to one of the plateaus, Starsnash Cliff, it seemed like it was cut in half and was pushed over. To add more curiosity, the traveler also mentioned how strange it looks like. So now if you climb to the top of the cathedral, it does look like a half mountain. Now this could have happened because of Venti reshaping Mondstadt, as it's shown that he could literally drop entire mountains into the sea. However, if you look at the whole Valley of Windrise on the map and again from the cathedral, it kinda looks like an impact crater. We are not sure whether it was from the sky or maybe an elemental disaster occurred. And from the impact crater, this could be the reason why Mondstadt is on an incline, as you can see. It is possible that this was the result of the events that took place 500 years ago, when Mondstadt was still ruled by a tyrant. So there we have it. Those are the 5 things you may have missed in Mondstadt. Now let's get to the few extra bits I want to mention. For bonus number 1, Hilichurls are using flaming flowers to pull the huge pot at, I apologize if I mispronounce, the Daupa Gorge. Do you remember the quest Moonfinger, where we boiled 3 samples of Noctilucus Jade? If you head to the bottom of the pot, you can see 2 flaming flowers placed below the huge pot. It seems that this is no coincidence, considering the fact that Hilichurls can actually think like humans and not just mindless enemies. For the second bonus thing is that you can actually find 2 miHoYo logos in the houses near Dawn Winery. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say this, but this is actually one of the watermarks miHoYo placed. Apparently, there was a company that made a game which used Genshin's textures. A lot of people noticed, and so miHoYo sued them for copying. This company lost the lawsuit because miHoYo hid their logo on a texture which wasn't noticed. miHoYo eventually won the lawsuit. It's a fairly small detail and also a smart way to put watermarks on textures. And so those were the 5 things you may have missed in Mondstadt. We are looking forward to your comments down below and whether or not you actually missed any of these things. Also, if I said anything wrong, feel free to comment down below. Finally, thank you very much for watching, and until the next one, be safe and stay tuned.